So let's talk about proteins, the key molecular building blocks for every organism on Earth. But how exactly are these proteins made in a cell? For starters, the instructions for making proteins are written in a cell's DNA in the form of genes. If we recall back to the central dogma of molecular biology, it goes from DNA to RNA to protein. And a gene is used to build a protein in a two-step process. So in one of my previous videos, I talked about the process of transcription, how a DNA sequence of a gene is rewritten into the form of RNA to make a final product called a messenger RNA, or mRNA. In this video, I'll be talking about translation. So in this stage, the mRNA that was made from transcription is going to be decoded to build a protein that contains a specific series of amino acids. So during translation, a cell reads the information in a messenger RNA and uses it to build a protein. But to be a little bit more technical, an mRNA doesn't always encode or provide instructions for a whole protein. Instead, we can confidently say that it'll always encode a polypeptide, or a chain of amino acids. And the polypeptide will then later be further processed to form a protein. But going back to mRNAs, the instructions for building a polypeptide are the RNA nucleotides, so A's, U's, C's, and G's, and they're read in groups of three. These groups of three are called codons, and there are 61 codons for amino acids, and each of them is read to specify a certain amino acid out of the 20 commonly found in proteins. One codon, for instance, known as AUG, specifies the amino acid methionine, and also acts as a start codon to signal the start of protein construction. There are three more codons that do not specify amino acids. These are called stop codons. These tell the cell when a polypeptide is complete. Altogether, this collection of codon and amino acid relationships is called the genetic code, because it lets cells decode an mRNA into a chain of amino acids. But how exactly is an mRNA read to make a polypeptide? There are two types of molecules with key roles in translation, which are tRNAs and ribosomes. So transfer RNAs, also called tRNAs, are the molecular bridges that connect mRNA codons to the amino acids that they encode. One end of each tRNA has a sequence of three nucleotides called an anticodon, and this can bind to specific mRNA codons. The other end of the tRNA carries the amino acids specified by the codons. There are many different types of tRNAs. Each type reads one or a few codons and brings the right amino acids matching those codons. So ribosomes are the structures where polypeptides or proteins are built. They're made up of protein and RNA. Each ribosome has two subunits, a large one and a small one, which come together around an mRNA. The ribosome provides a set of slots where the tRNAs can find their matching codons on the mRNA template and deliver their amino acids. These slots are called the A, P, and E sites. Not only that, but the ribosomes also act as an enzyme, catalyzing the chemical reaction that links amino acids together to make that polypeptide chain. So now that we know all of the key players of translation, let's go into more of each of the steps. To see how cells make proteins, we can divide translation into three stages: initiation, elongation, and termination. So in initiation, the ribosome assembles around the mRNA to be read, and the first tRNA, remember, this carries the amino acid methionine, which matches the start codon AUG. This setup, called the initiation complex, is needed in order for translation to get started. And now in the next step, called elongation, this is where the amino acid chains will get longer. In elongation, the mRNA is read one codon at a time, and the amino acid matching each codon is added to the growing protein chain delivered by tRNAs. So each time a new codon is exposed, a matching tRNA will bind to the codon. The existing amino acid chain is linked onto the amino acid of the tRNA via a chemical reaction. And then the mRNA is shifted one codon over in the ribosome, exposing a new codon for reading. And this cycle continues. During elongation, tRNAs move through the A, P, and E sites of the ribosome. And this process repeats as many times as new codons are read and new amino acids are added to the chain. And finally, we have the last step, called termination. This is a stage in which the finished polypeptide chain will be released. It begins when a stop codon, UAG, UAA, or UGA, enters the ribosome, triggering a series of events that separate the chain from its tRNA and allow it to drift away from the ribosome. So after termination, you have a polypeptide chain. This polypeptide chain might still need to fold into the right 3D shape, undergo processing, and get shipped to the right place in the cell, or even combine with other polypeptides before it can fully do its job as a functional protein.